Hello everyone, and if you feel that concept of brand positioning is unclear to you, you are watching the right video. After watching this, you can analyze the positioning of any brand. So let's start. Every consumer has a different need, and whenever we want something, we choose. Let's see this from an example. Suppose I need a car, then there are different options like hatchback, sedan, SUV. Then comes whether it should be luxurious, or it should have good features and interiors, or it should have only basic features. Now I will start choosing, and every person evaluates it differently. For me, if I have to choose luxurious SUV, then I will buy a BMW car. But if I choose SUV with good features and interiors, I will buy a Toyota Fortuner. While there are various car brands in the market, but this is my choice. So what has BMW and Toyota done to me? They have created a brand positioning in my mind. By doing this, they have ensured that whenever I think about buying luxurious SUV, I should choose BMW amongst all different competitor brands available in market like Mercedes or Audi. And hence, brand positioning is that unique space which brand occupies in the brains of the customer. Positioning statement is different from taglines because positioning statement is internal and tagline is what company communicates to external world. We will see this from an example later in the video. Brand positioning can be done via anything, whether it is pricing, promotions, distribution, or packaging. Think about it. What comes first to your mind when you hear that a product is from China or from Europe? Can you observe that without seeing the product, you make that first impression? Now that is the positioning which that particular country has created in your mind. The goal remains the same. That is to create a unique impression in your mind so that you associate something specific and desirable. Brand positioning can happen intentionally or unintentionally, but brands want to do it intentionally so that you choose them over the competition while buying a particular product. From any brand positioning statement, you get a lot of information, and to understand it better, we have categorized it into four parts. All these four information you will get once you analyze a positioning statement. First is audience. Brand has created product for whom and how brand addresses a customer pain point or their need. Second is market. In which market category a brand operates and why it is better than competition in that market. Third is brand promise. What will customer achieve when he goes with your brand? What brand promises to customer? And the last is reason to believe. Why should customer believe in the brand? So all these elements are part of position statement, which takes a form something like this. Now this is just a template, and it might be possible that brand doesn't follow this template, but it will include all key elements that we have listed. Let's see position statement of two different companies. Now this is the position statement of Apple. Now let's find all four elements in the statement. So Apple audience is individuals who want the best personal computer or mobile device, and their market is technology industry. What Apple promises that they will deliver the most innovative product so that customers can enjoy seamless experience across all Apple devices and be empowered with breakthrough services. And why customers should believe them? Because Apple takes an innovative approach to businesses best practices. So now you know all the four elements of Apple. If we see the Apple tagline, it is think different. Now, if I'm an Apple employee, it means I have to think different to make innovative products. And if I'm a customer using Apple product, it gives me a different feeling, and that's why people love Apple products. If you observe here, tagline is in sync with brand positioning statement. So any brand has to come up with positioning statement first, and it is the guiding principle for all marketing communications like tagline. We will now see second example of Disney. Their positioning statement is this. Let's find all the four elements again. So Disney audience is children, their parents, friends and family, and their market is entertainment and media industry. Walt Disney promises that they will preserve the magic of childhood. And why should customer believe them? Because they combine product, services, and experience across many sectors. The tagline for Disney is happiest place on earth. Now, if I'm using any Disney product And because their brand promises that they will preserve my magic of childhood, I am at happiest place on earth. So now, with this knowledge, you can analyze any brand vision statement and comment if you want us to make video on any topic which you find difficult. I hope you like the explanation in this video. If you have not subscribed, do that to stay updated on different concepts and their applications. We will meet in next video.